Welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to be doing a simple mirror upgrade for the rear view mirror. If you didn't know, most of these Toyotas use a very universal Gentex mirror that has the auto dimming plus the Homelink on the bottom. And if your car didn't already come with this mirror or the Homelink, it's an easy upgrade with a very cheap mirror that you could get on most junkyards or even buy brand new. The mirror itself only uses power, ground, and a constant power. And a lot of times the power is already up in your console, so you don't have to do much wiring. On today's video, we'll go ahead and install this in there and figure out the wiring on a Toyota Avalon, so stay tuned. So right here, we've got the Gentex mirror. This one doesn't have a compass. All it has is a Homelink and the auto dimming. This one you can find on most newer Lexus vehicles, the IS, the ES, or any new, basically like 2010, 2011 and up. You gotta be careful when you're looking for these because of the Homelink versions, especially if you have a Chamberlain garage door opener or a LiftMaster. So the newer LiftMasters and Chamberlains require Homelink 4.0 to work just because of the code hopping. So on these mirrors, when you're looking for them, you have to look at the numbers on the back. If it ends with an HL4, that means that's Homelink 4. Any mirror that you find on eBay or online that has HL3 means it has 3.0 and it won't work with Chamberlain or LiftMasters. That's just a FYI. You can still use Homelink 3.0 on the Chamberlains and LiftMasters if you get a bridge, which is about $25 to $30. So as far as the wiring goes on this particular mirror right here, you can see there's a white and black, that's the ground for Toyotas. There's a black wire, this is the power for the auto dimming. If you look on here, I'm testing it right now. You can see the green light right there is on. You can turn it off. And if you switch the wire over to the pink is gonna be your Homelink wire. You can test it by plugging it up and the Homelink buttons work right there. So right now, those are the only three wires we have to hook up. The auto dimming wire needs to go to a switch power source that only turns on when the car is there. And then the pink wire for the Homelink needs to be on constant all the time. Some people don't like it constant just because it's a security risk. So you can hook that pink wire up to the switch power so it only works when the car is on. We're in my Avalon here. This is an XLE, basically base model with no sunroof. So what we're gonna be doing is pulling this console down and looking for the power source. That way we can power the mirror right here. So to remove this thing, all you have to do is just put your fingers into there or use like a little clip popper like this, tuck it down there and then just basically just force it down because it's only held on by some clips right above the ceiling. So you could do it basically with one hand like I just did. So you can see right there, there's four clips that just pop right into the ceiling and it's pretty easy right there just to remove it. Once we get this down, disconnect the wire harness and then we can start multimetering to figure out which wire is which. All right, so off camera, I went through all these wires and figured out what everything is. So the little green, black, white, and red on the bottom there, that's actually for the microphone for the Bluetooth. So we won't be messing with any of that right here. So for the power and ground, they made it all confusing on here. They're basically all brown wires. So these two wires on this side, which is pins 9 and 10, are actually the constant power 12 volt that's always hot. So we're gonna be using that for the Homelink on this car. The next wire right there is another brown wire, and that's the constant ground. So that wire right there is for the door light circuit to be on all the time. The one after that, it skips a space, then it goes over. So the one after that is a wire that when the door closes, it actually does a slight dimming, like a step dimming down. And that one also turns off your dome light in case you leave your lights on all the time. So this last brown and black wire is the real dome light that you could just turn on whenever you want. So to get the switch power, I need to go down here. There was a wire I had identified on one of my previous videos that we can use. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull one wire all the way from down here, all the way up this pillar, all the way up there just to get the power for the mirror. So in order to fish that wire over here across this thing, we need to get into this pillar right here to tuck the wire in. The pillar comes out pretty easily. You could just pop this thing off right here and then it all just pops right out. So what you can do is just get a little pry tool, tuck it right under here and then just kind of pull it out. It doesn't go all the way out without kind of getting into there because this is designed to just stay like this when the airbag deploys because the airbag goes this way. So you actually have to put a little flathead or something right here, turn that little black thing in order to disconnect and dislodge this thing so you can pull it out. You gotta might need some needle nose to get that in. So let me get some tools to pop that out. We got needle nose, so you just wanna gently just turn this thing and get it in between. Just pull it out, careful not to break it. So once that's loose, then you can pull the whole, it's kind of tucked into the dash, so I'll just leave it at that. But right now we have access to everything back here that we can play with and pull some wires through. So here's that little piece that holds the top of the pillar out. You can just twist it and actually pop it off pretty easily once it comes out. But yeah, there's just little squeezes on the side, so you could actually just squeeze it without doing what I did. In order to get over here, we got to pop the side off. Right here is pretty easily. Right here, then just take this part off. Little nut here, you can just unspin with your hand. Pretty much get into here. And we had already identified this blue wire right here that comes out right there. Just to confirm before we start, I'm gonna go multimeter just to see. So right now, it's off. Turn the car on. So right there, it turns on to 12 volts, drops. So that is a 12 volt source. So we'll go ahead, tap that wire in here, and we're gonna go ahead, fish the wire through across here. I'm just using some 16 gauge primary wire. If you guys need any of this stuff, go ahead and check out the links down in the description if you need any of this wires or anything I use on this video. So go ahead, just kind of run it over. We wanna run it through here right now just so we can fish it across, and then we'll tuck it away. So we'll just pull it straight up. All right, so once we get it over here, just make sure you wire manage it right here, because the airbag gets out of the way right over here anyway. So we'll just get it to the lowest clip, tuck it around here, and then just basically, you could pull this rubber out right here. You don't get it out of the way for a little bit to work with, and just tuck it under here and right behind. You could pull this panel out too right here to make it easier. And then you want to just run the wire behind everything back here down to the bottom. I was able to run everything down, get it right behind everything there, tuck it behind the plastic, and then get it behind the metal right here down to the bottom. Go ahead, tap that in, solder it up, put some electrical tape and seal it up. So for that wire harness for the mirror, I extended it a little bit with some extra wire so I can actually reach where I need to. The black wire on here, which is the switch power, I'm gonna go ahead and do it on the car. I've got the heat shrink here already, and then we should be good here. All right, so right here, I've got the harness right there plugged up to the wire that we pulled down there, and we'll go ahead and just solder that and heat shrink it. So for the wires, I went ahead and spliced it. So right here is gonna be the positive side. I just spliced one of those two wires, and then the ground on this side, I went ahead and just spliced that back. I'm gonna go ahead, wrap the new wire, solder it, and then just put some electrical tape over this and then tape it all up. Down here for that little harness, I unplugged it so I can work on it. I already went ahead and spliced it right there. Got my red wire ready to go, so I'm gonna go ahead and do the same down here. All right, we got everything tucked back in here, taped up. I ran it up to here, tucked it around the edge right here under this little metal thing right here, and then over to the front. So that's pretty much wire managed. This thing's pretty much open right now. So the mirror install is gonna be pretty simple. It's just one little Allen key right here. This thing slides right up. You slide the new mirror on, plug up the harness, slide that little wire connector and cover on, and it should work right after that. So this thing is actually a T20 star bit. So we go ahead, just unscrew it slightly and just slide it right off. Then we go ahead and just slide the new one right on. Slides right on there, tighten it. If you want to make it easier, just maybe plug this up first and then put it onto there, but we already got it on. Snap that in. There is a wire cover that you can get with these mirrors. You just slide it right over. So we'll go ahead, put it right here, slide it up, and it just covers that up. Slide this thing up,
And then if everything's good, we go ahead and tighten it down just to make sure the mirror is in there.
All right, so right now it's in, it's good. Turn on the power and test it all out. So everything works now, checking the Homelink. The car is not on, it works perfectly good there. Go ahead, turn the power on. So we got the power on right now. You can see the auto dimming is working. Turn it off and it goes all back to normal. So this thing's good to go now. So we got this in the car and I was doing some testing and I noticed one thing about using the power for the dome light here. When the dome light is actually on, the power or the constant power in here, there's not enough juice to actually run the Homelink on here. When the lights are off, the Homelink actually works and blinks. So I was able to multimeter and double check again. So apparently the two wires on the end, pins 9 and 10, aren't the same circuit. So the 10 circuit is actually switched with the lighting system in here. 9 pin is the one that's actually always constant, even with the dome lights on or off. So I'm gonna have to go ahead and just take apart that and rewire it to that second pin next to it to make it work. But at least we figured it out and it's gonna work 100% after this. Hey guys, thanks for watching all the way to the end of this video. I'm putting in that Homelink mirror with the auto dimming. As you can see, it's a pretty simple wiring job, especially if you already have all the wiring on the console. For our particular car, we had 2 of the 3 wires. We had to run 1 wire on the side all the way down, but that was a pretty easy connection and very easy access. If you guys found this video useful, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Turn on bell notifications to get notified every time I upload a video. For all these different DIY projects, whether it's on the cars, in the garage, on the house, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you guys for watching and I'll talk to you guys next time.